You probably have seen caster wheels on shopping carts, chairs, and etc. But can we use them in NXT robotics? I will tell you today. Every competition robot needs a set of anchor points other than the motorized wheels in order to be stable. Today, I'll show you the most common type of anchors and of course their pros and cons. One pair of caster wheels. That's the most basic type of caster or wheels. The building instructions can be found at the link in the description. Some pros are that those wheels are really, really maneuverable, which helps in a lot of situations because they are turning 360 degrees. Of course, they could be built really easy for less than a minute, which is also a great thing. I'll now present to you the disadvantages of the caster wheels. There's a slight deviation after exiting a turn. I can show you in my little program here. The robot goes straight and then turns left. So do the caster wheels. To go backwards or forward, the caster wheels need some distance to straighten up. This could be a huge disadvantage on the competition mat. Of course, another disadvantage is that if the robot gets heavy because of plugins or because of the structure, the caster wheels could be bent, and this will cause the robot to lose the balance. A quick fix for the loss of balance: two pairs of caster wheels. This idea is similar, but the solution is better for heavier robots, which need better balancing. If you turn hardly with one caster wheels pair, the heavy bot is going to lose control. Like this, the force is divided equally to the caster wheels. Advantages. Your robot actually has better balancing. And the thing we got from the caster wheels is the maneuverability, and it's fast for building, really. But the disadvantages, what do we have? Our problem from the first chapter is now multiplied by 2. Now the deviation is twice greater because we have 2 pairs of caster wheels. Now that we've seen those 2 ideas, which pros are less than their cons, I could present you the solution which most of the competitive teams use: no caster wheels. By using this method, we guarantee ourselves that deviation cannot occur because we use stabilized parts which do not move, as you could see. I'm only going to show you one of the ideas you could use. Try to use your imagination to figure out new and better ideas for this particular problem. It doesn't matter if you used one stabilized tire wheel or studless parts or something else, the pros and cons are similar. Now, as you have seen all of those methods, you can try use them on your robot and see which one works best for you. Hope we see you again.